Welcome to Dating, Marriage and Life Stories with Kansiime. To all our returning guests and all the new guests, you're so much welcome. We do not take your time for granted. And I will kindly ask you to look at the subscribe button. In the event that you're not subscribed, please subscribe and like the video and drop us a comment and let us grow together as we learn from this very good channel. Following on last week's video, today we are looking at the seven things that are turnoffs for women in a relationship. The things that a man should never do to a lady if they are in a relationship, if that relationship has to continue, because they are a really turnoff. And these are things that men do either knowingly or unknowingly, or in whatever manner they do them. It doesn't matter what reason you're doing these things for, but they are a complete turnoff for women, and they could cost you that girl of your dreams. They could bring this relationship to an end, or they could bring an emotional blackout, and you're in a relationship and there is nothing interesting. You really have to change. Men, you really have to change on these things. Listen carefully from the first one to the last one, and I will reserve the best for the last that men need to really work on so much. Number one, bad personal hygiene. Women cannot stand a man with very bad personal hygiene. A man that comes and throws the socks around, smelly socks around. A man that, you know, just removes his shirt and he's sweated and is just throwing it all over the place, doesn't even know where the baskets are. You just come, scatter the shirts, scatter the trousers, scatter the jackets, everywhere in the house, your clothes are scattered. A man who doesn't bathe, you know, you just enter the bed, you've been there the whole day and you've sweated and you know the dust is too much and the car fumes, then you just want to come and just sink in the bed. Not acceptable for women. Change, bad personal hygiene is not acceptable for women. Number two, women cannot stand insecurity. A man with insecurity, a man with very low self-confidence, you know, you're just there all the time asking this woman, why are you talking to the other people? Do you like me? You know, do you love me enough? What are those things? Why don't you do these things if you like me? A man who is not secure in a relationship, no woman will like you. Women want a man that they are confident, a man that is confident. You know, she looks at you, you're confident, you have control, the things that you do. You know, this girl doesn't have to assure you all the time. If she likes you, she comes to you and she has told you she loves you. She's given up all the other people. She's right there with you. And then you're asking, oh, do you really like me? If you like me, why don't you do this? If you like me, why don't you sleep with me? If you like me, why are you talking to the other guys? Women are turned off by insecure guys, the guys who need constant assurance, the guys who need constant reminders about the love and the relationship that they are in. Number three, girls are turned off by a guy who is really so close to the ex. I mean, she's your ex. You gave her up. You came to this girl. You married this lady. And then all of a sudden, you're like, oh, my ex is my friend. We just hang out. There's nothing between us. That is a big lie. That is a big lie. How would you like it if this girl, the girl you have, the lady that you have married, if she chooses to go back to her ex, would it be just business as usual? It cannot. So stop chatting with your exes. Stop hanging around with them. Stop sending them those late night messages. Stop pampering your exes. They are in your past. Stick with this girl that you have. Stick with the lady that you have married. She is your present, and she's going to be the source of your blessing and an excellent future for you. Number four, girls are turned off by disrespectful men and poor listeners. It's a combination. A disrespectful man is going to be a poor listener. He doesn't listen to you. He doesn't take time to listen to what you're saying. Even when he's just there and you think you're talking and he's hearing, he's busy in his newspapers, he's busy, you know, checking out his phone, he's busy watching news. He would even tell you, you've talked enough. I really want to watch the news. And you're like, God, is there any respect for this person? You know, you're talking to him and he's busy calling his friends. You are with his family and you're with friends. He doesn't pay any particular attention to you. Girls are turned off. You disrespect her with your people, with your relatives, with your friends, and you are siding with your in-laws against her, and you're siding with your friends, you judge her in public. Disrespect is a big turn off for women. Number five, exaggerated masculinity. You want to prove that this lady, that you're the man in the house. In fact, you even come announcing, do you know who the man is here in this house? Who is the man? Who is in charge? You know, you want to be a man. You are disciplining children, you're beating. You're talking to this man, this lady, you want to shout at her. You are exaggerating being a man, being masculine. Stop exaggerating. It is a big turnoff for women. Women know who the husband is. The moment you start announcing to her who is the man in this relationship, who is the man in this home, it means you are not sure about your position. And it means you have left the position you are supposed to be in and you have come down. So stop being in that exaggerated masculinity, pretending to be more man than you are. You can't help her wash the dishes. You can't help lay the bed. You can't just do anything. You are a man. Mr. Man, that lady, once she stands off, she's going to give up on this relationship and no woman will want you, because what takes one woman will take another one. So stop being too man. You are man enough. Stop trying too hard to be a man. Number six, girls are turned off with men who have no purpose. You wake up today, you have no dream. There is nothing you're chasing. There is nothing that is inspiring you. You are just lazy. You are not doing anything. You are already saying, ninayoka deal. I have this deal. When it comes through, I will buy this. Just a deal. There has to be something that you are inspired to do. There must be something that you're chasing and you're working so hard at. There must be some effort that you're putting in to make sure that you earn a living. Men, you turn off ladies if you are lazy. If you are living without any purpose. You have this girl, you don't know how you're going to bring out her rent. And then she brings the money, you receive it. She pays for the rent, you accept it. She does one or two things, and you're there. You're there waiting for her to do the things. They send children from school, she pays the rent, and you're there. What are you doing? Women are turned off. And the moment she throws in a towel, she is done with you, and you're not going to see her again. Or she may not even walk out, but she will cut you out completely, emotionally, and everything that has to do with you. You will never have this woman again, the one that you were relating with happily. The moment you lose her emotionally, she's gone for good. Number seven, the biggest one. Women are turned off by non-performers in the bedroom. What do I mean by this? Are women so sexholics? No. A lady wants a man who will touch her. A man who knows how to put her in the mood. She wants a man who will talk to her and hold her in the hand and hold her in the chest and, you know, make her feel a woman. And when you have put her in the mood, that moment that you know, your moment of glory, and you're coming to do the actual sex, do it well and well enough. You know, women will start and they will finish so fast. And then they will roll the other side and sleep, and they start, you know, rolling like lions, and they are tired and they are snoring. And you leave this poor woman there. She has just started and you have finished. Let me tell you, if you leave her there, emotionally she is drained. She is drying out. She's craving for you and she cannot have you. And then it turns into anger. And the next day you want to touch her, she will not accept you. What do you do when you're making love? Prepare this woman very well. You know, by the time you're starting on her, she is already up there. Make sure you finish together. Don't finish and you run away. And if you have a problem, you have a weakness, you know it happened once. And you know it happens just once. And when it happens once, you start losing confidence. And when you start losing confidence, it will happen again, it will happen again and again. And then you are one man short, one bullet person. That's how they call them, chisasi chimu. The moment you start behaving chisasi chimu, then the man stops operating. And when that happens, look for help. Seek for help. Make sure you're treated and make sure you're not so selfish to your woman. You need to satisfy her because you're the only one that she has. And when she's satisfied, you both will enjoy. Emotionally, you're good. When sex is good, you are all good emotionally. Physically, you will be good. Your relationship will blossom. I wish you all a blossoming relationship and good tidings in your marriage, in your dating, in everything that you have to do. Kindly remember to subscribe. When you subscribe, I grow and I'll be giving you more content. When you like my video, then it will be easy for you to find them up on YouTube and across Google. Let's grow together as we build our relationships together. God bless you. Goodbye.